Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, infinite glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Forgive me the spirit to do this lesson. Yahweh, being the name of the Heavenly Father, Bahashem, meaning in the name of Yahweh Shai, being the name of Yahweh's only begotten Son and our Lord and Savior, also who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, Bahashem Rakakwadash, meaning in the name of the Holy Spirit. The bondage to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, and shalom to the hopeful elect that scatter abroad to the four corners of the earth, which are you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, and shalom to you speckled birds and you Israelite faunas that scatter out in other nations that look like other nations, but are, in fact, Israelites. And the title of this lesson is The Plagues as Before, all right? You know, this lesson is ultimately inspired, you know, off of 2nd Ezra chapter 15, you know, where it talks about how, you know, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai is going to, you know, bring plagues as before upon Egypt, all right, roughly paraphrasing. And, you know, it's not talking about ancient Egypt, all right, because Yahweh Bashem Yahushai already did that, you know, when he was in Egypt, you know, in captivity, you know, before he was delivered, you know, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai brought plagues upon Egypt, all right. You know, it's not talking about ancient Egypt, it's talking about spiritual Egypt. All right. You know, in spiritual Egypt, you know, is ultimately America. All right. What you have to understand, you know, America is considered, you know, many different ancient kingdoms all in one. All right. You know, ancient Nineveh, ancient Babylon, Sodom and Gomorrah, Rome, Greece, so on and so forth. All right. You know, many different kingdoms all in one. You know, but right now we're talking about how, you know, we're talking about spiritual Egypt. All right. You know, the scriptures tell you that the Lord is going to bring plagues as before upon Egypt, all right? You know, before he delivers, you know, the children of Israel out of this place, all right? You know, so through the spirit, you know, I want to do a quick lesson on this, all right? It shouldn't be too long, straight to the point, all right? Because we are living in those times, you know, where we're about to see a lot of things, you know, that look, you know, supernatural, all right, happening here in America, Babylon the Great. All right, you know, famines, pestilences, all right, you know, so on and so forth, you know, things worse than what you've seen take place in 2020, all right, you should already know what I'm trying to hint at, you know, but I can't say it because of YouTube's algorithm, so on and so forth, all right, you know, we're finna see some major strange events taking place here in Babylon the Great, all right, and the scripture said, you know, it will happen, the Lord is going to bring plagues upon Egypt as before. All right, so, you know, through the spirit, you know, this should be a fairly quick lesson, straight to the point. All right, we're going to go ahead and hop into it. So before I even get into 2nd Ezra chapter 15, you know, I want to bring out Jeremiah chapter 16 to show you that, you know, it's going to be a second Exodus, all right? You know, I'm pretty sure a majority of you brothers that have been, you know, tuned into this truth for a minute, you know, tuned into this channel, you already probably knew about it. You know, before you knew her, brothers and you knew her sisters, you know, a second Exodus is going to take place, all right? And it's going to surpass the first one, all right? Let's read it. This is Jeremiah chapter 16, and let's start at verse 14. It says, "Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall no more be said, the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt." Verse 15, "But the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north, and from all the lands whither he had driven them, and I will bring them again into the land that I gave unto their fathers." All right. So these are the times that we're living in. All right. We're about to, you know, witness, you know, a second Exodus that's going to surpass the first Exodus. All right. You know, and during the first Exodus, we already know what took place. Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know, he brought many different plagues, you know, upon ancient Egypt. All right. You could read about it starting in Exodus chapter 7, I believe. All right. You know, I'm going to touch on it a little bit, you know, in this lesson, you know, but you could read about it starting at Exodus chapter 7 all the way to chapter 10, I believe. All right. You know, the Lord brought, you know, about 10 plagues. All right. Upon ancient Egypt, you know, and when you read 2nd Ezra chapter 15, you know, it tells you that the Lord is going to bring plagues upon Egypt as before, roughly paraphrasing. All right. You know, and these plagues are going to be far worse because, as we just read, nobody's going to be talking about the first Exodus anymore, because this second Exodus is going to surpass the first one, all right? You know, it's going to surpass it, you know, drastically, Because the Lord, he's finna bring major judgment to Babylon the Great, America, all right? Spiritual Egypt. So let's jump to Revelation chapter 11 to show you that this place is ultimately, you know, spiritual Egypt. This is Revelation chapter 11, and let's start at verse 8. All right, and it says, and their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. All right. So it's talking about, it said their dead bodies shall lie in the streets of that great city. All right. It's not talking about literal dead bodies. It's talking about spiritual dead bodies. All right. When you look around at the vast majority of our people, you know, we're in a dead state. All right. Brain dead, the walking dead, literally. All right. Don't know what the hell is going on. Don't know who we are. You know, still thinking we're African Americans, you know, Latinos, you know, Native Americans, so on and so forth, whatever the case may be. All right. You know, we're spiritually dead. So it said our dead body shall lie in the street of the great city, which is called spiritual Sodom and Egypt. All right. And it's no question as to why, you know, this place will be considered, you know, spiritual Sodom. Just look around and see what's going on and read about what was going on in ancient Sodom and Gomorrah. All right. You know, a lot of, you know, alphabet people. All right. You know, a lot of, them type of people. I just put it like that. All right. You know, I'm not going to say too much because of YouTube's algorithm. All right. And it's called, this place is also referred to as spiritual Egypt, you know, because, you know, a lot of, you know, different monuments that you would see in ancient Egypt is here in Babylon the Great. It's here in America. All right. Look at the back of your dollar. You see the pyramid. You know, look at the Washington Monument. All right. You know, it's the same as the Egyptian obelisk, you know, so on and so forth. All right. So it's a lot of correlations between America and ancient Egypt, which is why America is called spiritual Egypt. All right. So now that we got that, you know, out the way, you know, you see that America is ultimately spiritual Egypt. Let's go ahead and go to Exodus chapter 7. You know, and I'm not going to read the whole thing. I'm not going to go into all the, you know, plagues that was ultimately put on ancient Egypt, you know, because that would take a little while, you know. But I just want to show you that the Lord, he put plagues on ancient Egypt. All right. So let's start at Exodus chapter 7 and verse 1. And it says, and the Lord said unto Moses, see, I have made thee a God to Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. Verse 2, and thou shalt speak all that I command thee, and Aaron thy brother shall speak unto Pharaoh, and he sent that he send the children of Israel out of his land. Verse 3, I will harden Pharaoh's heart, and will multiply my signs and wonders, and my wonders in the land of Egypt. All right, so, you know, ultimately, Yahweh Shem Yahushai, you know, he sent Aaron, he sent Moses and Aaron, you know, down to Egypt, you know, to tell Pharaoh to let the nation of Israel go. All right, and the Lord purposely hardened Pharaoh's heart just so the Lord could show forth, you know, his might, his power, right, by the way of sending various plagues upon the land of Egypt. So it's going to be the same way here in America, all right? The Lord, you know, he's going to bring plagues upon this place, you know, just to show forth his power, right? His might, right? Because, you know, America has bigged up themselves for a long time to the point, you know, where they feel as if they can't be brought down low, all right? But now we're in the times where Yahweh Shem Yahushai is getting ready to bring great plagues upon this place and bring America down low, all right? This place is about to get humbled by the way of various plagues, all right? You know, famine, pestilences, great death and destruction, all right? You know, things that you have never seen before, things that you will think you only see in movies is getting ready to take place here in America in real time, all right? Verse 4. And it says, but Pharaoh shall not hearken unto you, that I may lay my hand upon Egypt and bring forth my armies and my people, the children of Israel, out of the land of Egypt by great judgments. All right. You know, so that's what the Lord did back then. He hardened Pharaoh's heart just to show forth his might, his power and whatnot. All right. So everybody, you know, will fear the one and true living power, Yahweh Shem Yahushai. So the Lord, he's about to do the same thing this time around. All right. So verse 5, and it says, and the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I stretch forth my hand upon Egypt and bring out the children of Israel from among them. All right. You know, and when Yahweh Shem Yahushai do it this time, everybody's going to know who the true one, one and only power is. All right. Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. All right. So let's jump to Exodus chapter 10 and let's read about, you know, how the Lord brought some of these curses upon ancient Egypt. All right. This is Exodus chapter 10 and verse 1. And it says, "And the Lord said unto Moses, Go in unto Pharaoh, for I have hardened his heart and the heart of his servants, that I may show these my signs before him. Verse 2, and that thou mayest tell in the ears of my son, of thy son, and of thy son's son, what things I have wrought in Egypt, and my signs which I have done among them, that ye may know that I am the Lord." All right. So the Lord, he brought these different plagues upon ancient Egypt, so it will be known for many generations what the Lord did. All right. You know, and as we read Jeremiah chapter 16, you know, the Lord, you know, he's about to bring forth the second Exodus, and nobody's going to talk about that first Exodus no more, because the second Exodus is going to surpass what happened in the first Exodus. All right. You know, so, you know, yeah, you know, major things is about to be seen taking place here in Babylon the Great. All right. America in spiritual Egypt. Let's continue. All right. So lock you. You know, so I believe it was at verse 3, all right? And it says, "And Moses and Aaron came in unto Pharaoh and said unto him, Thus saith the Lord Yahweh of the Hebrews, How long wilt thou refuse to humble thyself before me? Let my people go, that they may serve me. Verse 4, Else if thou refuse to let my people go, behold, tomorrow will I bring the locusts into thy coast." All right. So this is one of the plagues that Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai brought upon ancient Egypt. All right. Locust. Verse 5. And it says, "And they shall cover the face of the earth, that no one cannot be able to see the earth. And they shall eat the residue of that which is escaped, which remaineth unto you from the hail, and shall eat every tree which groweth for you out of the field." All right. Because hail, you know, that was one of the plagues as well that came upon ancient Egypt. Verse 6, and it says, "And they shall fill thy houses and the houses of all thy servants and the houses of all the Egyptians, which neither thy fathers nor thy father's fathers have seen since the day that they were upon the earth unto this day." And he turned himself and went out from Pharaoh. Verse 7, and Pharaoh's servant said unto him, "How long shall this man be a snare unto us? Let the men go, that they may serve the Lord their power. Knowest thou not yet that Egypt is destroyed?" All right. So Pharaoh's servant's pretty much telling Pharaoh, like, hey, just let them go. All right. You know, Egypt is getting destroyed. All right. You know, but Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai hardened Pharaoh's heart again, you know, just so he could show forth his might and his power. All right, let's continue. Verse 8, and it says, "And Moses and Aaron were brought again unto Pharaoh and said unto them, Go, serve the Lord your power. But who are they that shall go? And Moses said, We will go with our young and with our old, with our sons and with our daughters, with our flocks and with our herds will we go. For we must hold a feast unto the Lord. Verse 10, and he said unto them, Let the Lord be so with you, as I will let you go, and your little ones look to it. For evil is before you. Verse 11, not so. Go now, ye that are men, and serve the Lord, for that ye did desire. And they were driven out from Pharaoh's presence. Verse 12, and the Lord said unto Moses, Stretch out thy hand over the land of Egypt for the locusts, that they may come upon the land of Egypt, and eat every herb of the land, even all that the hail hath left." All right. So, hey, this is the plague of locusts getting ready to come upon the land of Egypt. All right. Verse 13, it says, "And Moses stretched forth his rod over the land of Egypt, and the Lord brought an east wind upon the land all that day and all that night. And when it was morning, the east wind brought the locusts, and the locusts went up all over the land of Egypt and rested in all the coasts of Egypt, where Salakia, very grievous were they before them were no such locusts as they, neither after them shall be such." Verse 15, "For they covered the face of the whole earth, so that the land was darkened, and they did eat every herb of the land, and all the fruit of the trees which the hail had left, and there remained none any green thing in the trees or in the herbs of the field through all the land of Egypt. All right, so these locusts, they came, you know, they ate up all the herbs on and so forth, right? This is one of the plagues. Verse 16, then Pharaoh called for Moses and Aaron in haste, and he said, I have sinned against the Lord your power and against you. Now therefore forgive, I pray thee, my sins only, Salaki, my sins only this once, and entreat the Lord your power that he may take away from me this death only. Verse 18, and he went out from Pharaoh and entreated the Lord, and the Lord turned a mighty strong west wind, which took away the locusts and cast them into the Red Sea. There remained not one locust in all the coast of Egypt. But the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart so that he would not let the children of Israel go. All right, so the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart once again. And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thy hand toward heaven, that there shall be darkness over the land of Egypt, even darkness which may be felt. All right, so the land of Egypt, you know, they suffered darkness, pure darkness for about 3 days. All right, you know, so the darkness was so dark that they even felt it. All right, you know what I'm saying? So just imagine, you know, what it's going to be like in this time. All right, you know, just imagine the Lord bringing pure darkness upon, you know, spiritual Egypt, America. All right, you know, it's finna get ugly out here. Verse 22, and it says, and Moses stretched forth his hand toward heaven, and there was a thick darkness in the land of Egypt 3 days. They saw not one another, neither arose any from his place for 3 days, but all the children of Israel had light in their dwellings. All right, that just show you that, you know, Yahweh Shem Yahushua, he's going to make sure that his, you know, chosen, his elect is good. All right, you know, but the Egyptians, you know, they had darkness 3 whole days. All right, and it says, and Pharaoh called unto Moses and said, go ye serve the Lord, only let your flocks and your herds be stayed, let your little ones also go with you. All right, so lock you. Verse 26, and it says, our cattle also go with us, there shall not be any hoof be left behind, for thereof must we take to serve the Lord your our power, and we know not with what we must serve the Lord until we come thither. Verse 27, but the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart, and he would not let them go. All right, so Pharaoh did it once again. And Pharaoh said unto him, get thee from me, take heed to thyself, see my face no more, for in that day thou seest my face, thou shalt die. And Pharaoh said, Moses said, thou hast spoken well, I will see thy face again no more. All right, you know, so I'm not going to read all of it, you know, they're pretty, they're pretty much be kind of long, you know, if I went over every single curse and whatnot, so like every single plague, you know, but you get the point. All right, you see how Yahweh Shem Yahushua brought plagues upon ancient Egypt. All right, you know, locusts, you know, hail, darkness for 3 days. All right, you know, he turned their rivers, you know, into blood. All right, that was one of the plagues as well. All right, you know what I'm saying? It was 10 plagues altogether, you know. And the scriptures told us that the Lord, he's going to be bring plagues upon Egypt as before. All right, now let's get into the point of me doing this lesson. This is 2nd Esdras chapter 15, and let's start at verse 5. All right, and it says, behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. All right, and we are living in those times. All right, we're seeing all the chaos that's erupting around the world. All right, you know, we see in these different countries, China, you know, they're trying to play out cyber attacks on America. All right, you know, great death and destruction is coming to this world, but chiefly spiritual Egypt, which is America. All right, verse 6, for wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore thus saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually. All right, you know, sincere brothers, sincere sisters, you know, are crying out to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai day in and day out, asking for deliverance, right? You know, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai hears it. That's why the Lord, he's getting ready to bring, you know, the second Exodus, bring plagues upon this place and bring, you know, deliverance to the elect, all right? Verse 9, and it says, and therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Verse 10, all right, now we're getting to the point. It says, behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt, all right? And this is not talking about ancient Egypt, all right? You know, this is talking about spiritual Egypt, because this is where the vast majority of the Israelites are, all right? You know, yeah, we're scattered in all places upon the earth. You know, some of us may be still in Egypt, all right? You know, but the vast majority of Israelites as a whole, all right, we're here in Americas, all right? You know, North America, this is where the Exodus, the main, you know, the main deliverance is going to be taking place, all right? You know, the elect is going to be delivered out of all places where we're scattered, but, you know, the Exodus, the, you know, is chiefly going to be here, all right? Let's continue. Verse 11, it says, but I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before and will destroy all the land thereof, all right? So, hey, we just read about some of the plagues that the Lord brought upon ancient Egypt, right? You know, we saw how cold that was, you know, so just imagine what the Lord is getting ready to do to spiritual Egypt, all right? You know, you Israelites that haven't repented, you know, that want to continue to, you know, cling on to the ways of Babylon the Great, you know, spiritual Egypt, you're going to get caught up in these plagues, all right? Because of the first Exodus, the Lord delivered all of Israel. Right, but we know, pursuing to Zechariah chapter 13, verses 8 and 9, you know, only one third is going to make it out, all right, and survive what's getting ready to take place. But two thirds of our people is going to be destroyed, all right, you know, with these plagues that's getting ready to come upon, you know, spiritual Egypt, all right. Let's continue. And it says, verse 12, Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai shall bring upon it, all right? Very dark times is getting ready to come upon this place, all right? Very dark times, you know, and these plagues is getting ready to come upon spiritual Egypt. Is going to be far worse than what, you know, we read about, you know, in the first Exodus, all right? You know, in ancient Egypt, you know? So with that, you know, Lord willing, you know, this lesson was edifying to your brothers and your sisters out there that scattered to the four corners of the earth. And as always, I want to give all praises, honor, and infinite glory to Yahweh, the Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Forgive me the spirit to do this lesson. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. And Shalom to you brothers that's out there pushing this truth and sincerity. Shalom.